Joshua Reynolds was Britain's most important portrait painter and one of the most influential artists of his time. And he was born right outside of Plymouth in Plympton in 1723. He made over 2,000 portraits in his lifetime and painted everyone from poets to royalty. And some of his earliest paintings are right here at Port Elliot in St. Germans in Cornwall. The Elliot family were some of Reynolds' first clients after he finished his apprenticeship in London and moved back to the West Country to set up his first portrait studio in Plymouth Dock, which is now Devonport. He painted several portraits of the Elliot family, and they would become his lifelong friends. One of the unusual things that Reynolds does in this portrait is that he paints her with her hand on her hip. This was a pose of power and assertiveness that was typically only used for portraits of men. Reynolds would later be a founding member and first president of the Royal Academy. There, he gave a series of lectures on art theory, and in them, he taught students about light and color. He said not to paint the textures of fabric, but to paint the contrasts of color to create that sense of drama. To celebrate the 300th anniversary of the birth of Sir Joshua Reynolds, we're working with Rana Begum, a Royal Academician, who's going to be creating new works in response to his paintings in our collection. And we're really excited to be working with her to celebrate this season of color and light.
To try not to go over onto the other side.
Oh yeah, yeah, it works really well.
For me, this is the first time where I am responding to a collection like this, which I haven't done before, and it's a really wonderful connection to have with the box and its acquisition. It's definitely something that's making me think a bit more about colour in a way that I haven't. It's making me think about the way I kind of respond to a space, respond to what else is happening in the space. So it's a great time to kind of be showing alongside Joshua Reynolds, and especially someone who is obsessed with colour like Joshua Reynolds. It's great to be able to show alongside his work. There's three paintings that I'm kind of responding to. One is a self-portrait by Joshua Reynolds, and in that painting there was something about it that kind of really pulled me in. And even though it's quite dark kind of surrounding, and you've got the portrait, the face kind of almost illuminated in the painting, there was something about it that it just kind of drew me in. I felt there was kind of drama in the painting, and I wanted to kind of pick up on that drama. I wanted to kind of pick up on the atmosphere that was created in that painting. So a lot of the, you can see kind of behind me as well, some of the tests that we've been doing, is really responding to that drama, responding to the atmosphere that's kind of created in the painting. We're not being literal in terms of responding to each colour specifically. So when we're looking at the painting, I'm looking at kind of more the effect of one colour against the other, looking at kind of how he's creating depth, how he's creating the effect of light as well, and how certain kind of features are kind of really brought out in the painting, whether they're kind of the lips or the cheeks, you know, the glow on the cheeks, you know. So that was kind of really fascinating, and then discovering how his kind of obsession with that red as well. So it's kind of, and that's what was really wonderful, to kind of see that obsessiveness and discovering that obsessiveness through the process and finding that connection, because I feel, you know, I have kind of similar approach. I do have this kind of obsession with colour and obsession with how one colour reacts with another.
That, and I'll track this one.
Normally, I work with paint straight out of the tube. So a lot of the colours that you see in my work are standard colours that are, you know, that straight out from a tube or a can, you know, that we spray. With this body of work, it's been really kind of mixing different kind of medium together, different kind of colours together to achieve a tonal effect, but also kind of a transparency and what happens when you layer. And that is really, it's kind of fascinating in terms of how the transparency, you know, using transparency and colour, and, you know, you can get that kind of depth. And we're at a stage now where you can get the transparency. You know, there are mediums that allow you to get the transparency, which, you know, it's amazing. I mean, I don't know how Joshua Reynolds would have reacted, you know, knowing the different kind of possibilities with materials. And so we're kind of in a really fortunate position where we can really try out and experiment, and knowing that actually we're experimenting with the right materials. Whereas he's using oil, I'm using acrylic as well. I'm not a big fan of oil paint. I end up having, you know, getting really messy. And so I like to kind of work in a certain way. So I'm trying to achieve transparency through a different medium. I was really, really kind of fascinated how he was kind of depicting fabric, and how sometime, you know, the fabrics had like weight and form to it. And that was really interesting in terms of how some of the fabric that he was kind of portraying in the paintings were metallic. And that's a, paint surface that I've been interested in for a long time, whether it's in kind of the folded relief pieces that I make, or the panel paintings or prints that I do. I've been interested in the metallic paint because of the way that it picks up light. And that got me thinking, and I was like, okay, well, how do I get that in these works, but also add movement to it? So with these paintings, you do have to move around, and you have to, so there's a kind of slight shift, you know, from his portraits. And in order to really fully experience these paintings, you have to move, you have to kind of walk around the space. And there have been moments where it kind of catches the light, because we've used within the paint, we've used some metallic paints to kind of pick up light and create movement. So I like the fact that there is something, you know, when you look, I'm hoping that you'll get to look at these paintings in relationship to each other. So when you look at it from a front on, there is something quite calm, quite kind of atmospheric, quite contemplative about these paintings. But the minute you shift your position in the space, it becomes alive. There's movement in the painting. In the same way, I feel, you know, the three paintings that I've selected have movement, have, you know, that kind of moment of like static kind of stillness. And that's why I think for me it was really exciting, you know, working with and responding to Joshua Reynolds' painting, because it felt like it was a challenge for me to kind of see, well, can I actually mix colors? Can I push myself in the way that I haven't done before? The Dappled Light show is a show that kind of really gives you a kind of in-depth view in terms of what the different processes, the different materials I use in the studio, and the different series that are happening or being produced in the studio. Dappled Light is a touring exhibition that it's on its fourth iteration at the Box. Majority of the work is going to be in St. Luke's, so I'm really excited how the cloud, mesh cloud, is going to respond to the space, to the double height space where there is natural light kind of flooding in through the window. I also love that St. Luke's has kind of, a space that is also quite intimate. So it's going to really draw the viewer into some of the works, whether the tile piece or the jasmonite or the spot paintings. So there's going to be lots of conversations happening between the works, and it'll be exciting to see how the viewer responds to it. When I make my work or in the process, I do think about how one would navigate a space or move around the work. So that's when I guess the viewer really comes in mind. But it's not really dictated by the viewer. It's dictated by the form, dictated by the interaction of colour and form and light, and the material and what that does to the form, and how the possibilities of the material, you have to move around the work to really get the material, understand the potential of the material as well.
Working with artists is one of the ways the box opens its collection to new ways of interpretation and considers the legacies of artists like Reynolds today.